In the mythos that is built up around the American West in books and films, few names resonate like Earp. One syllable, lots of legends, a few of which even hold up. So why do we know so little about his first wife? First, what we do know. The generation of Earps that included Wyatt and his brothers reveals a mixed bag of heroism and maybe not so heroism, romance and soul-crushing heartbreak. As Casey Teffertiller, author of 1999's Wyatt Earp, The Life Behind the Legend, wrote recently of Wyatt, "The new research shows an Earp who is anything but flawless, rather than an Earp who went through a lifetime of achievement, struggle, and disappointments. He made many poor decisions in his life, and a few very good ones. He was human." Now viewed largely in the popular imagination as a gunfighter, lawman, and perhaps gambler, Wyatt Earp's complicated humanity also includes his repeated attempts to be a family man. So in terms of what passed for marital ties on the American frontier, and that Earp humanity, what do we actually know? We know that Wyatt and some of his brothers were involved in the business end of brothels at various points. Wyatt and Morgan Earp worked as enforcers and were arrested repeatedly in 1872 for their involvement with prostitution. James and Virgil Earp both owned bordellos at one point or another.
Pimps.
It was not unusual for a client to fall in love with a prostitute and, much to the annoyance of the brothel's owner, marry her and remove her from the profession, or she might continue, which seemed to have been the case of James Earp's wife, Bessie, who was charged with prostitution in 1873 in Wichita, Kansas. So it's no surprise that Wyatt's second and third wives, Sally Heckel and Maddie Blaylock, also had a history of prostitution. But what might be a surprise is that apparently neither they nor Wyatt's fourth wife, Josephine Marcus, were actually married to Wyatt. It's true, Wyatt Earp only had one legally recorded marriage, which took place when he was about 22 years old. He was working as a town constable when he married Eurylla Sutherland, herself about 20, in a ceremony performed by Wyatt's father Nicholas, who was justice of the peace in Lamar, Missouri. How did they meet? Were they deeply in love? We don't know. We do know that after just 9 months of marriage, Mrs. Earp died, possibly of typhus, probably in childbirth. If so, the child was stillborn, and as far as we know, Wyatt's only child. In the days that followed, Wyatt sold their home and continued to work as a constable until he was replaced, accused of mismanagement of funds. He's later accused of a number of crimes, petty and otherwise, including horse theft, before starting his sideline in law enforcement. Did he go off the rails with grief? Was it depression? Hard to say, because like Wyatt Earp, the truth is complicated. All we really know for sure is that Mrs. Earp is now buried in Milford, Missouri, a few miles from Lamar. And we know he eventually found love, or at least companionship, three more times. After a brief stint with Sally Heckel, Earp fell for a woman named Maddie Blaylock. Wyatt and Maddie Blaylock arrived together in Tombstone, Arizona in 1879, though they may have met as early as 1871. When Morgan Earp was assassinated in the days after the OK Corral shootout, Maddie was sent to live with Wyatt's parents in California. The expectation was that once things had quieted down, he'd come get her. He never did. Instead, Maddie had been replaced by Josephine Sadie Marcus. No marriage record has been found, though Sadie claimed at various times that they had been married at sea. Whatever the strict legality of their relationship, Wyatt and Sadie stayed together for 47 years until his death in 1929. Josephine followed him in 1944. They're buried together in the Hills of Eternity Memorial Park in Colma, California. Did he finally find happiness with Maddie Blaylock or Josephine Marcus? Or was the mysterious Eurylla the love of his life? Hard to say, because like Wyatt Earp, the truth is complicated. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about history are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.